A quick review of seasons.
What causes Earth's seasons? Earth's seasons are caused by Earth's tilt on its axis. Instead of going straight up and down, Earth's axis tilts 23.5 degrees. Can you see why the tilt causes Earth to have seasons throughout the year? Let's find out. Here's the energy of the sun. Notice that it hits the lower half of Earth, called the southern hemisphere, most directly. The sun's energy hits the northern hemisphere too, but look at how the northern hemisphere is pointed away from the sun. Also, the light hits at an angle that causes the energy to be spread out over a greater area. So at this spot in Earth's revolution, it receives less of the sun's energy. When more of the sun's energy hits the southern hemisphere, it causes the temperature to go up. It's summertime. More sunlight, longer days. With less of the sun's energy hitting the northern hemisphere, it gets a lot colder. Put on your winter coat. Less sunlight, shorter days. Let's see how the seasons change as Earth revolves around the sun. So, why do seasons change? Because the tilt of Earth's axis causes the hemispheres to receive different amounts of the sun's energy. That's some cool science.
See if you can follow this.
The axis of the Earth is an imaginary line on which the Earth rotates. It links up the two poles. Both the axis and the Earth are tilted at an angle of 23.5 degrees during a revolution. The tilting of the axis results in direct sunlight falling on different places during different seasons. This causes variations in the duration of days, nights, and seasons. Relationship between the location of the overhead sun and the seasons. Similarly, the revolution of the Earth and the tilting of the axis results in different angle of the sun during different periods. When the sun is directly overhead, we call this the overhead sun. At this time, the Earth's surface and the midday sun forms a 90-degree angle. Different locations of the overhead sun results in variations in the amount of solar radiation received in different areas and at different periods. Spring equinox. On the 21st or 22nd of March. The overhead sun is over the equator. The equator receives the largest amount of solar radiation. At this time, the northern hemisphere is in the spring equinox, while the southern hemisphere is in the autumn equinox. The angle of the sun decreases towards the poles. On this day, the two hemispheres receive a similar amount of solar radiation, and the length of day and night is the same at all places on the Earth. After this day, it is spring in the northern hemisphere, where the day is longer than the night. In the southern hemisphere, it becomes autumn, when the day is shorter than the night. Summer solstice. On the 21st or 22nd of June, the overhead sun is over the Tropic of Cancer. It receives the largest amount of solar radiation. At this time, the northern hemisphere is in the summer solstice, while the southern hemisphere is in the winter solstice. The angle of the sun decreases towards the poles. On this day, the length of daytime of the northern hemisphere is the longest in the year, while that of the southern hemisphere is the shortest in the year. Besides, there are 24 hours of daylight at the Arctic Circle and 24 hours of darkness at the Antarctic Circle. Autumn equinox. On the 22nd or 23rd of September, the overhead sun is over the equator again. The equator receives the largest amount of solar radiation. On this day, the northern hemisphere is in the autumn equinox, while the southern hemisphere is in the spring equinox. The angle of the sun decreases towards the poles. On this day, the two hemispheres receive a similar amount of solar radiation, and the length of day and night is the same at all places on the Earth. After this day, it is autumn in the northern hemisphere, where the day is shorter than the night. In the southern hemisphere, it becomes spring, when the day is longer than the night. Winter solstice. On the 21st and 22nd of December, the overhead sun is over the Tropic of Capricorn. It receives the largest amount of solar radiation. On this day, the northern hemisphere is in the winter solstice, while the southern hemisphere is in the summer solstice. The angle of the sun decreases towards the poles. On this day, the length of daytime in the northern hemisphere is the shortest in the year, while that of the southern hemisphere is the longest in the year. There are 24 hours of darkness at the Arctic Circle and 24 hours of daylight at the Antarctic Circle.
As the Earth rotates, it looks like the sun is going across the sky. The sun is not really moving. It's the Earth that rotates below it. Picture yourself as an ant sitting on the Earth. Now look up in the sky. What's the sun gonna do? It'll look like the sun is moving across the sky, but you know the Earth is rotating below it. This also changes throughout the seasons. During summer, when the northern hemisphere is tilted toward the sun gets really high in the sky. It also makes a really long path across the sky. We get a lot of sunlight in terms of hours during the summer, and it gets really high. It's really intense sunlight. In winter, we don't get very much sunlight. The sun never gets really high in the sky, and it's pretty cold because of it. Not much sun, not very high in the sky, cold. Here's the sun's path in winter, summer, and the equinoxes.
sun, I say.